What gets me every time we come down here is, you know, we get caught up in our lives. Most of us have been blessed with a good foundation, a family, a great town, good schools. And I drive to New York City every day for work, 6 miles from my home. These people have none of that. You know, there's no foundation. There's no support staff. There's no family that can support them. And it's a cycle that just repeats itself. You have family that can't support their kids. It means that their kids aren't going to be able to do the same. They have no opportunities to be able to build their own lives. And you can see by being here, it's amazing what it does. It's the only supportive foundation these people have. It's the only shot they have at a real life to get the things that we all take for granted they don't have. Whether that's, you know, just a loving environment of support, a guidance, right and wrong, wanting them, you know, to learn to do the right thing, that there is a better life for them out there, to work hard at it. The ability to go to school, ability to get an education, ability to go get a job. And it's a cycle. I mean, you know, this was and is a charity for women and children. It's always been to support the women, to get them, you know, to provide the basic necessities of life or help them support that. For example, you know, the women who have young children, they can't go to school. It's not an option. There's nobody to watch the kids. So you have to provide daycare for them to be able to go to school, and then help them get a job. And then they can obviously then take over and supporting their own family, get a roof over their head or pay for their own roof over their head or their own meal on the table, give their kids a guidance and support for them to build a foundation. So it takes care of that cycle, but at the same time, we started here. If you start with where the women are, what happens to the people that are still haven't gotten there, the younger children, teenagers. So we've had to tackle that, which is just an amazing thing to see, is getting, you know, the teen programs that are completely full quickly. You take them off the street. You're giving them some, you know, some guidance and help, ability to, again, from an education, or be able to go to college, or be able to get a job. And it's just a great thing to see. It's amazing. I always think about, you know, everybody, and which is great. People write checks for charity and put it out there, which is absolutely fantastic. To come down here and actually see what's happening so close to where you live, so close to your home. You know, and I have young kids who, these kids have none of that. No opportunity that I've had that they will have, hopefully. And to be able to come down here and just give them that foundation and know you're seeing the results. Directly, you're seeing these people, you're making their lives. It's not money disappearing and hoping that somewhere it's gonna hit these people. Everything directly goes to this. It's a fantastic thing to be involved in. I was lucky to get involved through the Chanelis and McLaughlin family. And I remember back then it was more of a, out of respect to them, a payback, so to speak, for anything they've meant in my life, saying, okay, I'll get involved and help out strategically what I can do. And you get involved, I have to turn around and thank them because it's been an amazing thing. It's amazing to see what it does. And I can tell you this, everything we've been able to build here starts in a church basement to where it is now, having this big building that we built. And I know if we double this building, it's going to be full. I come from the business world, so I always have to think about growth. And you look at expansion or buying a company or building an office and thinking, okay, well, you know, how often are we going to grow? And then you're basing your build out on that. You know, if we're going to grow 10% a year, 20% a year, because you don't want to build it too much, because then you don't have an empty space or an empty, you know, cost structure. Here, I know whatever we built, it would be completely filled within minutes. It's just funding that's holding it back. Which is great to know how successful it is. It's terribly terrible to know how much of a need there is. And there is. We could build this, we could double this building. There's, Jen, who's the executive director, or anybody who's been on the board can sit around and turn, if you gave $1 million, if you gave $5 million, $10 million, whatever the number is, they would know exactly where it could go to use. And like I said, it's sad to know that there's such a need. Certainly it's so close to our home, but at the same time, it's great to know what it does and what it's doing for these people. It's been fantastic. It's always good to give back, but, and it's great here to know you're actually seeing what it's doing. And to think that, for me, is I had nothing to do with the family I was born into or the means that my parents were able to provide for me. I was in the deck of cards, so to speak, their hand that you receive, and I was fortunate and blessed to have that. It doesn't make me any better than anybody else. Some people don't have those opportunities or as much of an opportunity, and these people don't have any of them. You know, and I think it's our duty to give back and give them any sort of a foundation because there is no other alternative for them. That's the biggest key. There isn't. You know, if this isn't here, these kids, these women don't get educated. There's no other option. They can't go back to high school. There's nobody to watch their kids. There's no opportunity to go to go on. And the same happens to their kids and the kids that we already have. It's the only shot that they have of building a life. And you hear stories of, you know, the people that are in the after-school program or the teen program, how, you know, a couple of them now are getting scholarships to go to college. It's amazing to think that this person's life, who's real, who's downstairs, you know, never had this opportunity, would never have this opportunity as a building. A great person, great girl, doing very well, that wouldn't exist. She would have no opportunity. There would be no college. You know, she'd be, I don't even want to think of where it should be without it. And to be able to see it, and you know, it's exciting. It's exciting to know everything that gets done here. Like I said, the success that it's had. And to give back. I highly recommend anybody who even wants to see it, come here, see it, serve a meal, sit with a kid, read them a book. For anybody, you're a lawyer, come down. Got plenty of stuff for you to work on. If you're retired and all you have is a smile, could be used for any of these smiles. Anybody, a teacher, during the summer, you want to have extra hours, volunteer. Anybody who wants to come down, you get rewarded yourself just from being here and seeing it yourself.
Bring your family.
Bring your family, bring anybody. Let your kids see it. You know, I was obviously me being at Don Bosco, I want the kids to come down here. I know what it would do for me if I was that age and you're seeing, wow, what opportunities do I have in life? It's good for them to see what other people don't have. And I also realize that they should give back and how lucky they are. It's a great thing. This girl is gonna go to college, you know, and what I love is knowing where she came from, she's gonna be more hungry than anybody out there. You know, she's going to want it, and she appreciates everything that she has. And think of how that goes. Where does she go from there? She's going to get a job, hopefully. Or she's going to get back and get into volunteer work or social work, whatever she's going to do. It's a cycle. Where does that go? She gets married, she has kids, they have a better life. Where do those kids go? And it goes on and on and on. And that is the beauty. Once you see, you're breaking that cycle. Mary Help a Christian has given a couple of scholarships for kids to go to high school for a couple of girls. That's a start. That's absolutely fantastic. You're taking people out. I can't even tell you. You and I will not walk around here at night, let alone at 10:30 during the day, and see some of the things that you see. Yet these people are in this environment, especially during the summer. They got nowhere to go. You know, so us going to play in a playground or go to a lake or something, they're sitting outside in an area that you and I would never want to even walk in. So having the opportunity to go to some of these other areas, like Mary Hope Christians let them go there one day a week, or the camps that we have them going to, is fantastic. And so, you know, getting back to the education side, for them to get a scholarship and be able to go to school, I mean, what does that do? Then they're going to have a real opportunity to go to college, you know, and then go on and on. So I urge any school, and I'm going to be pushing Don Bosco, but any school, to offer the same type of thing. A couple of scholarships to kids that you're going to change their complete life about it. And it's amazing, you will build their life. The last thing I would urge anybody to do is come here. Come here and see for yourself. I promise you, you're gonna come and see, you're changing your life. Everything you're giving these kids, they're sponges. You know, they look for attention, for anything. Anything you're giving them is gonna completely change their life. It's one of the most amazing things I've been involved in. And I can't tell you enough, every dollar you get, whatever it is, whether it's your time, certainly your funds, anything, there's already a need for everything. So it's not, hey, we've got to figure out where we're going to put this. We can tell you exactly where it would go, and it's going to be gone. And the beauty of it is it's that successful. The bad news is that there's that much of a need for it. I can't tell you enough. I mean, I already have in my mind other buildings we need to build, and they would be filled. Every class we open is taken. You have kids running around the hallway. Anything we do, any other program we add, there's such a need for it. I would love to expand the teen classes or the daycare or more class for the women, housing down the road, anything else. There was such a need for it. It would mind-boggle you. So I would urge anybody, come down, spend an hour, spend a couple times. You're not going to want to leave. You'll see for yourself exactly what you're doing, and it's one of the best things I've ever been involved in.